Hello everybody, today I'm going to be talking about nutritional aids that I use within my training and my racing, and also how I rehydrate. But first, I'm feeling very, very peckish. I think I'm going to pop out to a local restaurant. Oh, this is a very nice restaurant. I'm absolutely famished. It's really lucky that this restaurant was here. Let's have a little look at the menu. Oh, the Wandering Mongrel. Quite a slim choice. Let me see if I can call the waiter over. Good evening, sir. My name is Cuthbert, and I will be your waiter for this evening. At the Wandering Mongrel, we serve only the finest of cuisines. Could I please take your drinks order?
Have I met you before somewhere? You look awfully familiar.
But sir, I don't think I've met you in my entire life. I've never set my eyes on you. Although I do a little bit of running here and there sometimes, only a few miles a week. Maybe where you've met me before.
Ah, you're a runner, I see.
May I please take your drinks order?
Yes, please. In terms of drinks, I'd really like a nice refreshing pint of Nuun Active, please. Maybe the tri-berry flavour.
Of course, sir. I shall bring your drinks for you very shortly. And what would sir care for from the menu?
Could I start with a Science and Sport Go Isotonic Energy Gel, please? The pineapple flavour. And from the mains, a Maurten Calf 100 from the main menu, please.
Very well, sir. I shall place the order and it will be with you very shortly. Here we are, sir. Our compliments of the chef.
The whole idea of this seems so much more appetizing. How am I supposed to eat these? They haven't even given me any water. What sort of restaurant is this?
So, slightly ridiculous, but a quite humorous name of a restaurant nonetheless. I'm not sure that the Wandering Mongrel is a place I'd probably want to eat in the real world, but certainly something very strange about that waiter. Can't quite put my finger on it. Certainly very familiar looking. So over the course of the last year or so, I've been very lucky to use a number of different gels, a number of different energy gels and kind of nutritional aids within my running, within my training. And I'd like to try to talk about those a little bit today, put across my feelings on them and give you some of my experiences. I'm always interested to try out new sort of things, new products and stuff. See how they shape up, you know, do they actually deliver what they say they're gonna? Sometimes it's a bit of a Neil Young situation, you know, you pay for this, but they actually give you that, you know, you get something else. So, been quite lucky really in terms of the nutritional aids that I've tested out. They've all seemed to work quite well for me with very limited side effects. Before we get started, I've got a bit of a question for you guys out there. Please comment below and tell me which nutritional aids, which energy gels you utilize within your races and your training. Which ones do you favor and why? Which nutritional aids are you planning to use within your races that you have coming up? When are you going to use them? You know, how do you figure out when you're going to utilize them? Please comment below and let me know. I love reading your comments. As you know, I try and answer every single one if I can. It drives my wife to despair, but it's got to be done. I really, really appreciate my viewers. I appreciate your support. Beast and I appreciate your support, don't we, Beast? Do we appreciate their support? Of course we do. Yeah, the Beast. This is the cat that's quite often charging into the studio and causing all sorts of havoc, but she's my loyal friend. We've been together a long time, haven't we, Beastie? I love my Beast, my faithful friend. So my recent half marathon attempt over in Salisbury all went very well up to a certain point and then not so well afterwards, but still a time I'm really proud of. 1:35. I'm pretty proud of that time. Within that half marathon attempt, I used a combination of different gels and I kind of positioned them at certain places to kind of give me a bit of a boost throughout the race. Those two gels were from Science in Sport and Maurten. I tend to buy the Science in Sport gels in massive big packs like this. It's a little bit more cost effective. You get like about, I think there was 30 in this one, a 30 pack. I've used up most of them. I need to get some more, but this is kind of what they look like. They're actually quite large in terms of size. I'll throw some stats up on the screen for you so you can see just how big they are. These gels are quite fluid and runny in terms of their consistency. They seem to be some really great deals on these gels actually, if you're prepared to sort of shell out sort of 20, 25 pounds. You can get massive boxes of them and they're often really great deals. They throw in free postage and all that kind of stuff, even though these are actually relatively heavy when you stick 30 of them together. With my last order. I think I got these down to about 70p per pack, which is great, really. You know, 70p, I find these gels really easy to consume. Well, I say that, but the only real downfall of them is actually trying to open the pack sometimes when your hands get a little bit perhaps sweaty or wet from moisture or rain or something. It can be a little bit difficult to try and rip that kind of top piece off. There's a few times I've ended up sort of grabbing them in my teeth and trying to rip them open, and unfortunately managing to fire some of the gel over me. So there we go. So relatively easy to consume them while mobile, which is obviously kind of when you want to try to use them. You don't really want to have to stop and consume these things. I found most of the different flavours to be quite acceptable, actually. There aren't really any that I've really found quite disgusting. I'm not a huge vanilla fan. Even that one was okay. Vanilla ice, that's what that always reminds me of, vanilla. In comparison, the Maurten gels are actually quite a lot shorter. You can see there's quite a difference in terms of the pack. They're around about the same width. In terms of weight, I think the Science and Sports quite a bit heavier. I think the tab on the Maurten gels is slightly easier to open. I've no issues with that. It's just you rip it off and it's gone. And due to the consistency of the gel, it tends to stay in there a little bit better if you don't want the whole gel at once. If you're kind of just wanting to use up a small bit of it over the course of perhaps half a mile or something, that's a little bit easier than with the Science and Sport gels. They're kind of like a one-shot deal, really. Once you've opened them, you've got to consume them. You can't really hold on to them. The gel just sort of comes out of the top. The Gel 100s and the Calf 100s are much more jelly-like in their consistency. And some people may find that a little bit more difficult to swallow. You need to kind of break the Maurten gel down a little bit in your mouth first, kind of like almost chomp it up a little bit to get it to a kind of size where you can swallow it. But once you do, it's dead easy to swallow. So in terms of energy from these things, there's about 100 kcals in this one, and I think there's about 87 in the Science and Sport gel. Don't forget, you've also got 100 milligrams of caffeine in this thing as well. It really is like adding some sort of rocket fuel to your body, this thing. It really does give you this massive kind of caffeine boost. That might be a good thing, that might be a bad thing, depending on how you handle caffeine. 22 grams of carbs in the Science and Sport gel and 25 in the Maurten gel. So in terms of size, I kind of find the Maurten gels a little bit less obtrusive. They're a slightly better shape, you know, they just fit in the pockets of those running shorts that little bit easier. I really do like the added sort of kick of the caffeine version of the Maurten gels. I've used the original ones, the Gel 500s before, and they work really well for me. But these do certainly give you a kick. As I say though, use with caution if you are not experienced with use of caffeine. If you're not a coffee drinker, it might have a unfortunate effect on you. I used one of these just for the start of the Salisbury Half Marathon. It certainly woke me up. We had quite a long journey over there, actually. I was hoping to get to the event a little bit earlier than I did. But when I did get there, there was quite a lot to do. You know, I felt a little bit hurried. But certainly having one of these just for the start of the race meant I was really ready to go and certainly had a lot of energy. Of course, with these gels, I think you do need to consider the price. At around about 70p per pack here, and you're looking at probably somewhere in the region of about £2 per pack here. Actually, let's just work that out. Actually, you're looking at probably closer towards £3 for one of these. It's a lot of money, really. I think something to be saved for race days, perhaps when you're doing a very long training session, or you're actually testing out your nutritional plan for a race day. Either that or you've won the lottery or something and you can just afford to use them all the time. So the Calf 100 gel, it's got a somewhat bitter taste. Those of you that enjoy caffeine, you're probably going to detect it straight away. I certainly did. The consistency of the gel is absolutely the same as the Gel 100. So you just literally get that slightly bitter taste and a real big shot of caffeine. I did check salt contents of both of these gels and they seem to be similar. I wouldn't say they're the same. There's not a huge amount of information on the Science and Sport gels in terms of salt content. I don't know, how much salt do you need? They say here that you can consume up to 3 of these gels per hour. I'm not sure what sort of extreme high intensity work you're going to be doing where you're going to need 3 of these per hour. I think that this type of gel here, the Calf 100, is something that you probably want to place in at very specific intervals within your race to try and give you that boost. I think it comes down to that sort of love of coffee, really, of caffeine. If you really feel that kick at the start of the race could help you out, I think that the CAF 100 could be a good choice. So in terms of hydration and like rehydration really, after my runs, after training, after races, I tend to go with the Nuun Active. This stuff's really great. I kind of like the fact that it comes in these kind of tablets. You can pretty much pour out about a pint of water and then let these tablets dissolve into the water. Normally takes about sort of 3-4 minutes for it to fully dissolve. I found these to be fantastic after long runs. They really do rehydrate you. You start feeling a little bit more like your old self quite soon after. I sweat a lot when I'm running, so I do tend to feel very dehydrated. I think that's been a problem actually in some races. Perhaps I haven't been able to take on enough water perhaps later in the race. Being non-elite athletes, you know, it's difficult for us all to have that guy, you know, cycling along beside us, passing us those water bottles or passing us bottles with our drinks in. We can't have them on tables and things like that. I don't know, I guess you could sort stuff like that out, but you know, we're kind of one people armies, aren't we? We've got to try and sort those things out for ourselves. So I always try and take on some water at water stations where possible. Not masses, but just enough to try and keep myself hydrated as much as I can during a race. It says to use one of these tablets per hour of exercise. So if you're doing something like a 10K maybe, you're clocking in at around about 45 minutes through to about an hour, you probably need one of these tablets. So key things in here are really salt and vitamin C. And of course you're getting that water back into your system. So rehydrating you, starting to balance out some of the materials within the blood. I try and rehydrate as soon as I can after a run. They say that there's that half an hour period for recovery. So making sure you're starting to rehydrate your body and getting some fuel back in there. That seemed to work for me. I've been, touch wood, got any wood anywhere? Somewhere. Touch wood, I've been injury free for a long time now, so I aim to keep it that way. Okay, that's pretty much all for me for today, guys. Thanks for watching. I really do appreciate it. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Please do comment below and let me know about which energy gels and rehydration methods you utilize for your training and your races. Give the video a thumbs up. Make sure you share it with other runners. My name's EDDBUD, and I'll be seeing you. And this is Beast, and she'll be seeing you too. Won't you, Beast?